Hello everybody and welcome back to the Homestead on the Hill. If it's your first time watching one of our videos, my name is Hein and my wife and I are building a new life in the semi-desert in the south of South Africa, trying to state-proof ourselves as much as possible. If you're from South Africa and you don't think that is necessary, you haven't been paying attention. Come to think of it, if you're from pretty much anywhere, you need to pay attention. Today's update focuses on infrastructure development, not construction. We are going off-grid, so we need to provide for our own water, sewage, and electricity. The very rocky terrain where we are building has been a challenge in digging holes. I realized that it would take weeks to dig a hole for our septic tank, so I decided to get a Backo from the neighboring farm to assist me with the digging. The small mountain pass you see here is also why we are not getting our building material delivered to the site, but rather at the commercial farm next door. While we had the Backo on site, we had them prepare the septic tank hole, the parking area above the house, as well as a level area up against the hill for our water tank farm. The Backo, or digger as it is commonly known here, is actually a bit light for the job it is asked to do here. Many farmers in the area would rather use an excavator weighing 50 plus tons rather than a TLB weighing in at around 12 tons. The septic tank is fairly big, enough for 4 to 6 people, even though it will only be the two of us living in the house. Rather too big than too small. The septic tank is about 1.7 meters high and 1.2 meters in diameter. Digging that hole by hand? No. The digger spent about 2.5 hours on the septic tank hole. By comparison, leveling the parking area above the house took less than 1/2 hour. The water tank area was also completed in about 1/2 hour, maybe a little bit more. I'd previously spent 1/2 day starting the water tank area by hand, and the digger was money well spent. Luckily, I had the 4x4 monster truck on hand to tow the water tank up the hill. Compare this with carrying the temporary 1000 liter water tank up my back, way back when we started. We prepared the water tank stand by raking the ground and removing all sharp rocks and leveling the ground as much as possible. Then we spread some fine aggregate before laying out a foam mat for the tank to stand on. This will ensure that no stones pierce the tank bottom once it is filled with 5,000 liters of water. Thank you. As you can see, the water tank is the first of six. Initially, we will fit only three, but eventually the tank farm will provide 30,000 liters of water. Next up was preparing the septic tank for burying. The digger was unable to dig the hole deep enough to fully bury the tank. We hit a rock plate, which I decided would be the bottom of the hole. My options were to replace the septic tank with a smaller 1000 liter tank, or to fill up around the top of the tank, which is only necessary on the lower side of the hole. I decided on the latter. In a future video, I will show how that works out. For our next video, we'll focus on the framing of the walls of our house. Hope to see you then. Bye for now.